33 right now. The highly contagious Delta variant is expected to become the dominant strain of the coronavirus in Virginia. The variant currently represents more than 80% of sequenced COVID cases in the country. You know, officials so far say they have no plans to reinstate mask mandates and social distancing restrictions, but do expect to see another surge of the coronavirus in the late summer or early fall, driven by the Delta variant. We wanted to get a little more info. Joining us now with more on the state of Virginia and the infections there is infectious disease physician at Virginia Hospital Center, Dr. Jennifer Primeggia. Good to see you this morning. I appreciate you joining us. You know, somebody was talking about this over the weekend, and they said that with this Delta variant, they referred to it as a pandemic amongst the unvaccinated. Is that accurate, or is it really still a pandemic for everyone?
Yes and yes. I think it is a pandemic that we are seeing, and those who are unvaccinated are at the highest risk of catching this infection, but it's truly a pandemic for everyone. We are even seeing cases of COVID in those who are vaccinated as well. So all of us are at risk.
Okay, so let's take it one step at a time. Let's go back to the unvaccinated right now and how that might impact things for everyone, because we've also heard surveys recently, up to 50% of those who are not vaccinated, in some cases even a higher percentage, say they're still not going to get vaccinated even with the Delta variant spreading. So if that happens, if they don't get vaccinated, what does that do? What happens?
So the World Health Organization calls the Delta variant the fastest and the fittest strain of variant that we have seen. These patients who are unvaccinated are at high risk of infection. They are highly contagious if infected. We know that for two reasons. Patients who are infected with Delta variant carry a much higher viral load than those who had the original strain of infection. That viral load is up to 1,000 times higher in their respiratory droplets. So they are spewing more virus, which can then infect other people. Also, these patients who are unvaccinated and become infected are infectious 2 days sooner. So these people who are unvaccinated are more likely to transmit the virus to others, others who are vaccinated and others who are unvaccinated. So they're placing all of us at a great risk, and I would greatly encourage them to get vaccinated if they have not done so.
So let's go back then to those who are vaccinated and the risk that that is therefore for them. If this Delta variant is as you described, the potency of it, if that is there a greater risk then of that being transferred to somebody who was already vaccinated than perhaps the strain that we saw months ago?
Yes. So again, the patients who are unvaccinated carry a much higher viral load. So they are transmitting this virus to others. And people who are vaccinated can still acquire this infection. And the part that we don't know is how transmissible are those vaccinated individuals to others. That part is still being worked out. And while the risk is unclear, I would encourage everyone to stay masked if they're in an indoor setting or in a crowded area.
For those who are vaccinated, and we've heard cases of this, even if you watch the Olympics and you hear of people who tested positive, who perhaps had tested positive months ago, the risk of getting sick with the vaccination, where does that stand right now? Obviously, it could impact your travel. It could impact you if you're an elite athlete. It can impact where you are in the games. But as far as the risk of getting sick if you are vaccinated, where is that right now?
So we know that the vaccines that we have reduce your risk of serious infection by about 88%. So there's a 12% chance that you could still get sick. Additionally, if you are ill from COVID, you may be asymptomatic or very mildly symptomatic with cold-like symptoms. So more likely, if you're vaccinated and you become ill, your illness is not going to be as severe as those who are unvaccinated.
So bottom line, doctor, and I ask you this because you're in Virginia, for Virginians, the risk of the Delta variant, where does that stand as far as dominant strain and how much we might see that increase or not in the near future?
So I think we're seeing the effects of Delta variant now. When you look at the case positivity rate in Virginia, since mid-June, the numbers have been rising steadily. We are up to 3.8% case positivity, and that number has peaked and curved up precipitously in the last few weeks. That's the effect of Delta variant. Now, we are not sequencing every case of COVID that we see. So the numbers that are being reported are just a fragment of what's really out there. But the precipitous rise that we're seeing is a reflection of Delta variant, which we know is much more contagious than the original strain.
Sure, going to have to wrap things up, but real quick, from your medical perspective, should we and or will we go back to wearing masks indoors and having the mask mandates in place?
So I have always encouraged my patients, especially those with underlying medical conditions, to continue to wear masks indoors for safety. And I think we all need to prepare for the possibility that whether vaccinated or unvaccinated, we will all need to go back to masking because this is such a highly contagious virus and because our vaccination rates aren't as high as we would like to see. So we're not all fully protected yet.
Dr. Jennifer Primeggia from Virginia Hospital Center, thanks for joining us this morning. We do appreciate it.